Good. Well, hello. Thank you for taking some time out of your day to sit in these comfy chairs and listen to the presentation. I'm Adam Jones with VIAVI Solutions. I'm a senior product line manager for the emergency alert systems portion of the company. What we're going to talk about today is really kind of my opinion and the need that doesn't currently exist for integrating emergency alert systems or those emergency messages into the over-the-top environment. I think if you'll notice, all of today's consumers are migrating away from the typical way that they consume media. They are moving to over-the-top platforms, different ways of consuming media than traditional broadcast or cable or IPTV or whatever you want to call, you know, traditional media. And as of right now, EAS has been completely out of that. And all of these offerings are now, you know, giving you live TV, traditional cable lineups, everything except for EAS. The problem with that is people have no forward-facing, you know, information as to critical events that may be happening in their area or anything like that. What they've tried to replace, not necessarily replace, but augment EAS with, are wireless emergency alerts. And, you know, just as a question, how many of you received this past fall's presidential test on your phones? Exactly. Right after that, how many of you tried to figure out how to turn those messages off? Right. So that's one of the problems is, we are reaching people in new and better ways and quicker and getting information, you know, directly to their watch, to their phone, or to what have you. But when there's a real emergency, people have turned all those notifications off because they just don't want to be bothered by them. And so I think where we're at is it's time to start addressing these things and get a real look at integrating emergency messaging into the over-the-top environment, especially in use cases where they are offering a cable-like bundle, local channels, things like that. So, excuse me for a minute. The over-the-top classification is really just a classification. And if you look at satellite, if you look at cable, if you look at IPTV, all that's addressed in Part 11. But all those people are doing is the exact same thing. They are delivering content directly to the customer. And that's exactly what over-the-top is doing. And so it should be addressed. You know, there are differences in the way that IPTV, satellite, and cable all address EAS. They have different restrictions or different rules as to how they are supposed to perform their obligations under Part 11. And a lot of those fall back into the way the technology existed at the time for that medium. So, you know, cable operators, they have similar restrictions or requirements as a broadcaster. There's a list of events based off of your state that they need to participate in. They need to do weekly tests, monthly tests, things like that, and it addresses all of their subscribers. If you look at IPTV, that solution kind of evolved. Initially, it was, well, we'll participate in a few of the things and we'll do maybe just a crawl over the video. And then as the middleware and the set-top boxes enhanced, then it was, okay, well now we can do a crawl and we can supplement program audio. So it's much closer to what you would see with what a broadcaster does or what a cable operator does. Satellite, they were integrated into Part 11 when they did not have those capabilities. There wasn't a local point of presence. And so what you see them doing is like a monthly test for a few of their channels and then another monthly test for a few of their channels. And so they're sort of participating, but not really. We have the opportunity with Over the Top, because it is an advanced platform at this point, to fully participate in Part 11 and provide the end customer with not only presidential messages or national emergencies, but also local point of presence alerts, such as a tornado warning or a child abduction emergency, maybe a blue alert where you're talking about police and fire local emergencies. Or in California, just this past year, there were quite a few forest fires, as you know, as we all know. But there were also quite a few issues where broadcasters, cable operators were fined because they were not properly, you know, participating according to what their state plan or their local emergency messaging plan was. And I think where we're at now is we have this very good opportunity to start addressing that and fix not only the way EAS is operating and currently being ingested, but also address how it is going to be ingested with over the top as it grows. And also, as you see, as cable operators not necessarily abandon traditional broadcast capabilities, but they're also moving into offering over the top platforms, and we see them as an operator offering EAS directly now, and we don't see some of the national over the top providers doing that. But I think personally the technology is there. A lot of the larger over the top providers have points of presence in all of your major markets already, which gives you a very good starting point for monitoring for and sending back these local messages. You know, nationwide messaging is very easy to do. A lot of those are handled now through the IPAWS interface, but then you also still have a backup over EAS radios. Where the key is now is utilizing not only your point of presence for receiving your local broadcasts and offering those to your viewers, but you can place a very low cost piece of hardware in. It monitors for those local messages and can send those back to whether it's your middleware or directly insert those over the streams. So as far as VIAVI is concerned, we have several pieces of hardware that can satisfy these requirements today. Our main platform, the EasyCap system, has multiple IOs as far as being able to integrate in with your middleware, being able to offer either multicast MPEG output, MPEG dash, we're working on HLS. So we can send and integrate in to your middleware those messages now. We also offer very low cost hardware that can be deployed out in the field where you do have these points of presence for local broadcast pickups and send those messages back either to our aggregators or send them directly into your middleware. So with that being said, does anyone have any questions? I'd be available over here at the side. I can address them here if it's that type of question. And also our booth is just over to the side there. If that's it, I do appreciate your attention today and the time. Thank you.